Did you invest in Toronto condo assignments? Are Toronto condo assignments still a good investment? Do they make any sense? Let's explore. Hello, friends. Yossi Kaplan here, Toronto real estate agent and mortgage broker with Search Realty Search Mortgage. And today I want to talk to you about the viability of investing in Toronto condo assignments. Now, obviously, before we start all this thing, you got to understand investing is a personal thing. It's a personalized thing. By no means, this is investing advice. I'm just going to share with you what I see, what I think, and you can share with me in the comments, whatever you like. So let's start. What is Toronto condo assignment? We went a lot to Toronto condo assignments. When the developer starts the pre-construction, when they sell it to all the investors, or whether they go to buy it to live or not, they're still investing. And then if they want to flip the unit before it's closing, before final registration, before it's deeded, they reassign the contract. They don't own it yet, so they reassign the contract to someone else. They get their deposit back. They don't have to close, and hopefully they make a bit of money on it. Usually they make a lot of money on it. So are these still good? You know, there's a lot of talk about investments are too expensive and da-da-da-da-da. So I wanna get into the next few videos into this and explore. So as you know, especially when we look at condos.ca, I'm going to open a new window for it. When you look in condos.ca, you see a few interesting things. First of all, you see that the price on condos.ca quite fluctuates. I saw it at 800 the other day. 768 is still higher than we've seen in previous years. And you can see the graph here. Now we're looking at 775 for the average. It was up to 807 a couple of days ago. It's dynamic. It's live. It changes as we go. But you can see that generally speaking, the price of real estate is always going up. And it has to do because of inflation, because of the economic situation, the geopolitical situation in the world, in Canada, so on and so forth. Now, assignments are interesting creature because they're not really documented. There's no one board for assignments. I'm going to show you a couple of ways to find them. But it's not like there's an MLS for assignments. You're actually not allowed to advertise them. Some people just go put them on MLS. Maybe they have permission. Maybe they don't. If they don't, you know, they can get into some hot water with developer, can refuse them the assignment to find them or do whatever they want. So I don't recommend doing that, of course, but you're allowed to bring a buyer and assign the unit. If you're not allowed to assign a unit, then no investor would buy. And if developers were not allowed people to assign the units, no one was going to buy from that developer. So obviously the entire industry is dependent on this, because a lot of people are early investors, and that's totally fine. It's like you buying Tesla a few years ago. You didn't think it's going to be that hot, that crazy, and then you can sell it later. Okay. Of course, selling assignments is a lot more complicated than selling a stock, because it's really a one stock that's worth $500,000 or $800,000. So there's quite complications, there's tax implications, but I'm just gonna focus on the value of assignments today. Yossi Kaplan here, twitter.com/YossiKaplan, YossiKaplan.com. Register to the Investor Insider if you like, name, email, mobile to get the newsletter. And let's look at some assignments and see what we can do with them. Okay, so go to torontocondos.sl.com, do it with me, okay? Go to the menu, go to the listings. I'm just gonna reload this page. Okay, go to the menu, go to listing, residential listings, residential search. Let's put Toronto. I'll show you how I find what is in the system. And the property type, I want to focus on condos. Okay, and the listing status, I want to uncheck the rentals. And in the keyword, I'll put assignment. Assignment. Okay, like kids spell. Yes, and search. So here you're gonna see only the units have been put into the system. There are way more units, of course, but they're just to give you an idea. Obviously, most of them are in the downtown core or downtown area for the simple reason there's just more product there. And when you see it, you'll see a lot of buildings, like right here, King Blue, which is just before completion. Okay, so you can see some prices: 700,000 for 600 square feet, 700,000 for 500 square feet, 37 floor. This is 8th floor. So maybe the price is a little lower. Maybe they want to sell faster, maybe because they have any view, don't have any view. Here's a 830,000 for 700 square feet. Here's 820 for 800 square feet, 2 plus 2. Here's 405 for 1. Here's one that's being reduced. By the way, this website, torontocondosforsale.com, can show you all the reduced too. Okay. If you don't know how to do it, put in the comment. I'll paste a link for you. Here's an 819 for 700 square feet. So you see the prices are well over $1,000 a foot. Okay. For example, 820,000, 18th floor, 700 square feet. Okay. So my calculator, 819,000 divided by 700. That's 1170 a foot. Okay. Here's another one, 910 for 800. So 910,000 divided by 800. At 1137 a foot. Now these are asking prices. That's not necessarily what they're gonna get. Here's 1,000,001 for 900 square feet. Let's try this one. That's 330 Richmond at Spadina. 1,100, 1,200, 1,300 divided by 900. That's 1,222 a foot. You can see where this is going, yeah? Here's Kingly, 949,000 divided by 800. 1186 a foot. So see, the average price here is around 1150 a foot, give or take. Okay, and it just keeps going on and on and on. There's a 668,000 divided by 500. That's 1336 a foot on the 47th floor. That's high. Okay, so it goes on and on and on. But you got to remember, if you're looking at new construction, you're looking at, for example, Untitled just came out. It's starting in the mid-1200s, 1250, and goes to 1300 and maybe even more for special units. So, you know, the developer would always give you the base price, which is the lowest floor unit with the crappiest view, usually no view on the lower floors because there's another building next to you, okay? And then it goes up from there, and, you know, you pay more for south exposure, western exposure, a bit of view, all that stuff you pay more for. If you're curious, let's go to the Google Maps for a second. Maps at google.com.ca. Okay, thank you very much. Toronto, Ontario. I love this city. We are so lucky and really so lucky to be living here. Like, you have no idea. This best place in the world is right here and right now. Let's celebrate this city. So I zoom in here. Can we do the 3D trick here? Oh, here we go. So the reason I do this is because it gives you a good idea. Look at all the density coming here, and obviously all the density is going to come along. This is Yonge, then Bate, then University, and then it spreads along towards the financial district and financial district here, and entertainment district here, and of course as you cross Spadina, you get to the King West. Okay, that's the King West triangle. Here is Bellwoods, all the way to here, and that's the Dufferin, and Dufferin, of course, starts Parkdale, which is also all this. Parkdale is quite large, and then it spills into High Park. These are your areas. So anything south of the tracks is traditionally has been more valuable, but now we're just pushing out because there's so many people come to Toronto. I saw these numbers the other day that about 80,000 people officially came to Toronto in 2017. So let's say unofficially, this is probably like double that. Easy 150,000 people coming to Toronto every year. In 10 years, you're looking at, you know, 1 million people, maybe 1.5 million. That's a huge, huge number of people coming to Toronto. No wonder why the subway is always, always busy. Blogto.com. I think that they had some, it's minus 21. There was something about the subway that was really, really busy. They got a lot of articles here. There you go. Look at this. Okay. So do you want to be on a subway? I don't know. I don't want to be on a subway anymore. I mean, if you are on a subway, maybe you should be on the university line or be right connected to the subway station. But obviously, the commuting is a big problem in Toronto and a big problem all over the world because the world was designed for cars, not for public transportation. And we just ran out of space for cars and parking and all that, these problems. It will be resolved in about 10 years. In Toronto, probably going to take 20. But, you know, the cars will drive themselves and everything will be fine, I believe. But it's going to take some time. In the meantime, there's time for us to make some money. So take a look at this. Here is a listing in condos.ca. This is 30 Ordnance. So this is on Strawn, around Fort York. There's no streetcar here. There's no subway. There's barely a bus coming in. And this unit is just a regular unit. Okay, there's nothing special about it, although the design's quite nice. And it's a one-bedroom asking 624,888. And that's about 592 square feet. So I'm going to go to my condo calculator. Okay. Condocalculator.ca. Put your name, your email, not a robot. And the system will send you a link. And you're going to download this file, which you can use on your computer in complete privacy. I do not know what you put in this file. I cannot track you. I did it on purpose. There's absolutely no way to track you. So this is for your own privacy. Okay, I don't need to know your numbers. This is for you. This is a gift. So I'm going to take this unit here, 30 Ordnance, unit 3205-624-888. Did I use it already? So it's 592 square feet, 592. I'm putting here 30 Ordnance. Okay, 624. So it's asking 1056 a foot. And if I'm doing a 2080, which I think you're gonna need more than 20% these days, my deposit $125,000 and the mortgage amount is about half a million. So my estimated condo fees according to my system at 68 cents a foot is 403. Can actually pop and see 372. So the maintenance fees are lower. Okay, so I'm gonna remove this down here. But remember, this is just the first year, 355. It's pretty close. That's good enough. Condo fees, municipal tax will estimate at 260 a month, and the mortgage is calculated to you by the formula up here. And you're welcome to play with the formula. There's no secrets here. Everything is disclosed in the open. And the carrying cost for this unit per month would be $3,000 a month, 2956. The break even for this unit right here, 30 ordinance, that I estimated 2956 a month. And because it only has one bedroom, the cost per bedroom divide by one, the same 2956, and the rent PSF required is $5 a foot, $5 a foot. Now the average rent is about $4 a foot, so this is 20% more rent per foot that we need to achieve. Now look at the price per foot here. It's telling us 1043 to 1250, but really no units have closed yet at Garrison. So I'm not sure where it's getting these numbers. Is it getting them from area units that close? Is it getting them from asking prices? It definitely, there is no reporting of how much assignments were sold for. So obviously these numbers, you got to take it with a grain of salt or a sack of salt, because I don't know where they got it from. It's not reported. So this number is either estimated or whatever.
Okay, now
Okay.
we're going to compare 30 ordinance unit 3205 to another unit that I have on the market. This unit, remember, it's 624888. It needs $3,000 a month to break even. It needs one bedroom, needs to rent it for $3,000 a month, get $3,000 a month in order to just break even, estimating. This is before any external costs. Okay, so now I got a unit here, 488 University Ave, 6495. Okay, so it's a very similar price. It's a one bedroom. It's slightly smaller, but it's on the subway line. It's on the subway line. Okay, so 488 University. Okay, you're right here at NASA St. Patrick Station. That means you can go into the subway right from the building. You're right on the subway line, and not only that, you're right on the right subway line on the university, which is much less crowded. And if you wanted to rent this unit to a doctor that works at any of the hospitals here, God bless all the doctors, all the good doctors that given us, and the nurses, and anyone that works there, okay? Let's pray for them and give them long life and wish them all kinds of good stuff. But nonetheless, they also make a lot of money and they're perfect tenants. So I would be willing, and that's personally me, busy day on King West, I would be willing to pay more for this unit. The asking for this unit is only basically $20,000 more. What do I got here? 624, 645, $25,000 more. So let's pop it in the system. 48 University. This one is 544 square feet. Okay. The balcony is 108, by the way, but it doesn't matter for the calculation. 6495. These are the asking prices. The PSF comes to 1149 on the asking. Your 20% deposit will be 129, and the mortgage will only be $20,000 more. Okay. The maintenance fee is actually slightly lower. It's going to be lower because it's a smaller unit. The tax is about the same. And the mortgage is about the same. I got 80 some dollars difference. Okay, so at the end here, my price is coming to 3026. So 44 plus what is this? Like $70. So $70 more a month. Okay, so this unit will cost. So these two units more or less cost $3,000 a month. Here is a unit is on the subway line, guaranteed. Okay, and here's a unit. Let's do directions here, and let's look at 30 ordinance. And I'll show you what I mean. Okay, let's switch the map. Okay, look at this. I'm gonna zoom out a bit. Okay, this is the subway line. The subway comes here and then goes down here to Union and comes up on Yonge. Right here, that's the loop. The King car, which is the closest streetcar, it's rammed because of all the Liberty Village. When you live here, you basically gotta walk. It's very windy. It's nice, but it's super windy. You gotta walk all the way here to King, and then basically compete with everyone that came before you on the train,
everyone that came here from King Street, from Liberty Village, lots and lots of people, and then from the West King West area to go to downtown. Now, I told you before, I don't think everyone needs to go downtown. I think that the measure of where your unit is from downtown has been the measuring stick, the yardstick for value, which makes sense but doesn't make sense because you got to look at the investment itself. In this case, if I can get a unit that more or less will cost me $3,000 a month, which one would I take? Would I take the one that will be right on the subway line on University, where I can get, or I can rent to a doctor or a surgeon that makes $1 million a year? Or I'm going to go to 30 Ordnance, I'm going to rent to someone who just finished university and make $60,000 or $70,000 a year, leaving them with free income of barely to pay for this unit? Where do I want my tenant to be, and who do I want my tenant to be? Okay, now I can also buy the West End unit, 500 square feet. Let's say it's a 550. We'll just fictitional unit, okay? And let's say this unit is $1,000 a foot, so 550, much cheaper. It's still $2,600, and it's still a terrible investment because it's 4.76 a foot. So the difference between 26 to 29 is not much. The difference from 29 to 3 is negligible. That means that this investment here, in my opinion, is the absolute best investment because the marginal cost, you know, $80 a month, a couple bucks a day, makes no difference. And what I can do, of course, is I can do what most immigrants do, is I don't have to put 20%. Let's see what happens if I put my 20% plus 20 more. So I'm just using the occupancy line here in number 19. You can follow with me, just download this file. So I put some more deposit, and this is across the board. I'm comparing all of them. Obviously the maintenance fees are the same, the municipal are the same, but now the mortgage amount drops, and you can see it's still about $80 a month difference here, and here is about $200 difference. So there's almost $300 difference between the West End unit and the 488 University, but there's only $75, $80 difference a month between 30 Ordnance, which is the end of the world, okay, for investing, to 488 University. Which unit will appreciate faster? Which unit is more guaranteed to get the best tenants? Which unit will get the millionaire tenant, and which unit will get the student tenant? Not only that, when you're investing in 30 Ordnance, you are looking at massive development with lots of buildings around it. There's an entire area. The entire playground condos right here is filled. There's actually five large buildings right there. You're looking at about 3,000 units right there. Where 488 University is very, very limited. And the reason it's limited, because there's just nothing else going on there. And it doesn't have a lot of units. And there's lots for rent, of course, because all the investors are offering theirs to rent, but there's none for sale. Once you can buy one, I think you're going to do really well. The price range is 544 to 1620. 544 is the smallest unit, the Collins model, the most efficient, cheapest model. If you go in another one bedroom, just the one bedroom, you're still stuck with one tenant, and you're basically buying a larger unit, and your ROI drops. Okay, the average PSF here, I don't know where they got it, because there's actually no data on sales for this building, so this is wrong. I just ignore it. The system is trying to find, maybe it's taken from Grange Park, from around, but you can tell there's just not enough stuff. And there's just not enough units. It says here 453, this is in planning, so this is old text, but there's maybe say 400 units or so, okay? And in the other one, there's about 3,000 units right here. Plus you got all the Liberty Village, of course, so the moment someone is actually gonna live at Ordnance, they're not going to compare just Ordnance, they're going to compare every other building to Ordnance. So you got the entire Liberty Village, which is massive, and there's two buildings missing here, and this entire block is built. You're looking at five new buildings. There's one here for the Cornerstone properties, and there's 51 East Liberty, and I think one more coming here, and then the 30 Ordnance. There's a cute little bridge here, which I really love, goes right to Fort York, which is really cool, but nonetheless, and very windy. And there's a whole bunch of stuff here. And then, of course, you get into the below Fort York and the whole by the water and the whole city place. It is very, very busy here. And don't forget that if you look at Tridale the Well, which is coming here on King Street. This picture is a little old, but it'll be all here. These units, there's nothing under 1400 foot. 1400, 1400 foot. And the cheapest pre-construction I can find now is Untitled, which is Yonge and Eglinton. That's about 1250 to 1300 foot, and there's lots and lots of units. And actually, Yonge and Eglinton, as good as it is, there's so many units. So now, in the new age of investing, I'm looking for scarcity. I'm looking to see what kind of pictures can, investments I can get that are rare, they will hold their value, and relatively a very, very good value to everything else around. So to me, 488 University makes a lot of sense. It makes a lot of sense because I can actually buy it for the same price I can buy inferior investments. Or if you're looking from the other way, why would I invest in a place that has so many units around and is not on subway, doesn't even have a streetcar, where I can pay slightly more, $20,000 more, which is mostly goes in your mortgage, I can pay $70 or $80 a month more and be right on the subway line. Wouldn't you like that? I mean, the tenant is gonna pay you that, okay? I think getting $100 a night at 488 University not gonna be such a big problem, especially once the building stabilizes and all the investors got their tenants. Don't forget, this is dead of winter now, in the middle of winter. Most people in Toronto move in July and August. In Montreal, everyone moves on July 1st. In Toronto, the window, you move all year, but most people come to Toronto as students or they come to work. Most work start after Labor Day, which is the first week or second week of September. So most people will move in July and August and a bit in September. That's when most of the rentals happen. So once we get to September, this building, or even before, maybe July, this building will be fully occupied, and then try to get a unit here. Then try to get a unit here. But guess what? You want to get a unit at 30 ordinance? No problem. I got 3,000 units for you here. And not only that, I got all these units here. Look at all these towers. You're competing with everything here. All these units. And there's more and more and more coming. And then you're competing with Liberty Village. And this is just what the picture shows, but there's more. There's all these area here. There's like five towers, maybe seven towers coming here. Each tower is at least 500 units. You're looking at another 3,500 units. Liberty Village is about 5,000 units at the moment, and we're adding another 3,000. You look at about 8,000 units on this corner alone. King of Spadina, in a different video I showed you, 411 King and everything around there, you're looking at about 2,000 or 3,000 more units. So I need scarcity. I'm a smart investor. I need scarcity. So the scarcity, in my opinion, is going to be on University at 488 University. Now, that's not the only one, but I think it's one of the smartest moves anyone can do right now. Anyone. Here, City of Toronto. Okay, this is a lot of money. This is power. This is lawyers. This is doctors. This is businesses. Okay, this is U of T, of course. This is Bay Street. Here's University. You see, it's an avenue. That's really nice. Okay, but you know, if you're a doctor, what are you gonna do? You're gonna live at the Grange. That's so old. You know, and then there's a few buildings. It's just, they don't have balconies, they smell. And the doctors tell me, like, we don't want to live there. We just don't. Like, it's like, why do I need to live there? I work so hard to become a doctor. I'm making close to $1 million a year. And I need to live in this, like, rat-infested building. And that's stuff they tell me. Or I can live on a St. Patrick's Station right here. Now, you can go to 481 University across the street, and that will cost you about $2,000 a foot, maybe $1,800 if you are on a deal. Yorkville, nothing under 1500 a foot, 1800 a foot. So if you can grab something at 1150 a foot right now, would you buy on a subway line downtown next to the doctor makes $1 million, or would you buy next to the students that just finished school and all going together, which is really nice, but you're competing with every other landlord in town and every other investor, and anyone that bought a Liberty Village paid less than you. That means that they can always undercut you in case there is a need to rent your unit. Someone else can undercut you because their costs are much lower than yours. So you want to compete on an even, what is it called? Even playing field? Even playing field. That's what you got to do. Okay. So a few more points and I'm done for this one, okay? Condo calculator, I showed you. It's very, very important you understand the difference between investing this kind of money here at the side of Toronto, no subway, no streetcar, obviously the bus is not going to be enough to put you on, okay? They're just like, look at this. You got to be smarter. You cannot invest on the subway line and anticipate just because you're a subway line, people got to run there. And you cannot think just because I'm in the core, it's going to work for me. It's got to be better. The prices have to be better. The building has to be better. Your unit has to be better. Everything has to be better so you can offer the person that is going to rent from you or buy from you a better deal than everyone else. And a better deal is about value. And what is value? Value is accumulation. It's the human accumulation of everything you've done before, everything you can offer. And that's what we focused on. So go to torontocondosforsale.com, do the search, run the assignments. Obviously, there's a lot, many, many, many more units and not listed here. There are tons of units. But I can tell you that if the average resale in town is about $1,000 a foot right now, okay, and the new construction is starting at 13 if you like not in the core, at 15 if you're close to the core, and 18 maybe if you're 41 University or if you're King West, the new project that is literally almost sold out, the 1800 a foot, or Yorkville, what should you do? You should get the best ROI. And to calculate your ROI, punch these numbers here. You know, you can change anything here. It's open. Just download it, play with it, and see what I mean. Now, could you get $2,500 a month for this unit? I think you could, and I think you will get $3,000 when it's furnished, and you can do a long-term furnish over 6 months. That's all you need to do. I don't think it's going to take very long to get a tenant there, and actually probably faster. You know, a doctor that comes to town is not looking for a vacant unit, and then they need to furnish it and all the furniture, and then I sleep on the floor. No, it's very cheap to furnish a one-bedroom. And that's what I would do. I would not run it as Airbnb. I would run it as long-term for executives. You know, I've had tenants from the Blue Jays and the hockey guys and the basketball guys. And I go to these guys, where are you from? I'm from the States. And what do you do? And the guy says, I run. And he shows me, he brings his fancy Mustang from the States. And that's what they do. They come for a couple of years. Maybe they're doctor and learning how to be a better surgeon, or because we have the best surgeons in the world, as you know. I'm a better promoter than what's his name down south of our own city and culture, but that's what it is. And I just can't tell you, and this is my personal opinion, but I can't really imagine if you could capture something like this, you wouldn't, and anyone will go to a lesser variances. Now, you can always buy at $1,000 foot resale. That's all good and dandy, but you're not going to get the crazy appreciation. You're just going to go with the market, and it's a secondary unit, or it's an investment unit already been lived in. It doesn't have the cachet, and definitely not the Sky Club on the 19th floor or anything that comes with 48 University. So I highly, highly urge you to open your eyes and your mind and look at the opportunities the way they are. And it's very, very difficult for a lot of people because things are moving so quickly and changing so quickly that it's really, really hard to understand where's it gonna come from. And especially if you've been around for a long time, and I've been around in Toronto for so many years now, even for me, it was very, very difficult at the beginning for me to kind of fathom and really get my mind around these things. Baths, always put a one bath kind of to kill everything else. So it's gonna give you everything, and we can do condo, all that stuff, but there's so many opportunities. Yossi.searchrealty.co. There are so many opportunities. The most important thing is to clarify the opportunities and run the numbers and see where you feel most safe, most secure, and what fits your investment profile. This is just everything from the most expensive. There are so many opportunities. Okay, last tip for today. Go to urbanrealtytoronto.com. Even Keely at $1,000 a foot to me was an amazing, amazing investment. Absolutely good. You can find the assignments on Tippett. If you want, I'll show you, which is the whole Keeley block. And they're still very good. And if you go to the bottom here, these are direct links to searches. So you want to see what's on King West, just hit that link there. I did it quick, but basically scroll to the bottom of urbanrealtytoronto.com and hit any of these links. You can hit assignments. And the system will just start opening links pre-programmed. So I pre-programmed King, and I can show you here. And you can see the prices actually for the resale are not cheaper than the assignments. They're not. Okay, this is a low floor, no view, 700,000. One bed, one bath. Okay, this is $1 million for 2 plus 2, ground floor, suite 109. That's how I know. This is your typical 530 for a one bedroom, okay? This is 550 for a one bedroom. So you can see this is 640 for one bedroom. Now, maybe this bedroom is a little larger, but imagine, and there's nothing wrong in 95 Bathurst, but you know, it doesn't have any amenities. It's a good building, it's King of Bathurst, I love it, it's a freight building, it's very nice, but it doesn't have any amenities. Now, it is an older unit, it's a larger unit, so it's got a large balcony, so it's a lifestyle unit, but it's not on the subway. It is on the streetcar level, it's on the fourth floor, which means a lot of Asians won't like it because they don't like the number four. We look here, the condo fees are 380 and the tax are 24, so that's about the same. That's about the same. So this unit, you know, will run you 639, will run you exactly the same as these units here, because here we'll put 639, so it's 10,000 less. That's a marginal error. So would you buy King West resale for the same price, 488 University on the suburb, glitzy with all the rich people are, or at Ordnance, which is no suburb and no streetcar? Okay, I think I made my point. The point is you gotta go for value and you gotta open your mind to see what value is. A lot of people get stuck on the number and they cannot see beyond the number and they don't understand the person who can achieve the same rate at a better location will win for the long run. Even if it costs you a little more today, in my opinion, it's all about value and quality, because there's so many condos, you have to start competing on value and quality. Okay, that's been going on for a long time. Thank you very much, Yossi Kaplan. Thank you for your like, thank you for your comments, thank you for your upvotes, downvotes, everything helps. I do respond to most comments in my own fashion, okay? So I'm gonna tell you exactly what I think, just like now, but there's lots of videos here. Go and teach yourself about what you need. Download the condo calculator, it's a very useful tool. TorontoCondos.com, TorontoCondosForSale.com. You can also see new construction. Just hit the projects here and do a little search, or search new condos by map. It's all there for you. There's untitled right there. Okay? That's it, friends. Good enough for today. Take care.